seriously, and it looks like we're going to have a battle right off the bat.
All right, the Bruin is Mark Potvin, and the Flyer is Dan Kordick.
And Kordick's a lefty. That always causes the problem. Well, that's three games in a row that the Flyers have used the knuckles.
And three games in a row, everybody who's here, the scouts, the Bobby Clark, were all smiling.
And you say, why an exhibition season? Well, Mike Kordick must have thrown 30 punches already. The Pistons were moving.
All of this at 10:40.
Trying to collect it in the corner. A hit. Oh, here we go. Armstrong going for Boston. And this is Kordick. Armstrong.
Armstrong changed hands.
Oh, winner! Armstrong! And,
I tell you, Kordick.
He beat a tough guy there.
I tell you, Kordick started it. I love to see that when the bully wants to start it. He starts it with Armstrong. Serious mistake.
This is Kordick. Armstrong.
Armstrong changed hands.
Oh, winner! Armstrong!
I tell you, Kordick.
He beat a tough guy there.
I tell you, Kordick started it. I love to see that when a bully wants to start it. He starts it with Armstrong. Serious mistake. He's laughing.
Daniel Lacroix. Now another battle. Brendan Witt has got right hand. And he's got something going with Scott Daniels. A heavyweight battle here. Witt and Daniels. Now Witt's got the left hand going. Look at these two throw punches.
That's a beauty. Witt, and there's Kordick. He's in the lineup. He was supposed to not play, but he got inserted in that fourth
line. And they're going again.
What a great fight.
This Kordick, you're right. I thought Kordick was out of today's game.
Look at that fight. Look at he's a little bit cut. Look at Winter. He's all smiles, got the hair going. What a great battle by Brendan Witt. There's Kordick cut big time on his schnoz. Brendan Witt getting the best of the tough guy for the Philadelphia Flyers.
And a well-earned congratulations from Chris Simon. Dan Kordick is
here. Here's the confidence against one of the tough guys. Look at this. Right, left, he starts out with his right. His right's gonna get tired. Then he's gonna switch to the left. That's what we heard about Brendan Witt in his junior days. And now he's doing it here in the National Hockey League level. Those guys both took a lot of punches, but Brendan Witt at the end getting the best of Kordick.
Well, Brendan Witt gets 5 minutes for fighting while Dan Kordick gets a 2 minute instigator penalty, 5 minutes for fighting, and a 10 minute misconduct.
And that's because he was sent right out at the stoppage of play there. You knew he was gonna get somebody after that Simon fight.
And have won only two of their last six here on home ice. They do have the 1-0 lead though here in the first period. And we got a fight on the far side as Kordick is at it.
And he throws with the left and Frankie LaRue throws with the right. And when that happens, somebody's gonna get hit.
Maybe the linesman.
If he chooses to get in there that quickly, Brace Campanello's got an advantage, though. He's about a foot shorter than both of those guys.
There's Dan Kordick, and there's LaRue. Two heavyweights who logged some time in yesterday's game in the penalty box will go right back there.
One of the members of this Dan line for the Flyers is not in the lineup. Scott Daniels is out of the game with a wrist injury. Got slashed yesterday. So Jason Bowen has taken his spot on this tough fourth line for the Flyers. Right on the faceoff, Dan Kordick went to Frankie LaRue, said hello. Away we go.
Kordick and LaRue had the last two penalties of yesterday's game. Kordick ended up with fighting on it. Only a couple the other way. Now they'll get five each in a wing.
In that game, Kevin Collins, the linesman, jumped in just to really stop it from getting carried away. And the boys beat the linesman to the punch on this one.
That's what happens when you have back-to-back games. You get to know one another.
Still getting to know you. Getting to hate you, boy.
Dearly.
Yeah.
So five each for fighting at 8:42. They will be gone. And Dejic did not get up to it. Now here we go again.
Man. Now Frankie LaRue got the jump on Dan Kordick on this one and threw a couple of rights and hit Dan Kordick, and he has hit him a couple of times again, forcing Kordick to turn into a righty. Dan Kordick, now Kordick's back with the left.
Kordick and LaRue had their first fighting in the first period. Both got five. They slipped at each other this time. They'll go again.
Francois LaRue pinched up into the neutral zone and really engaged Dan Kordick. I mean, he really kind of challenged him by pinching up on the play and banging into him on the boards. Dan Kordick answered the bell and said, uh-uh, you're not going to go out of your way to hit me and get away with it. Frankie, you go ahead and put the ice back on your hand this time, and we all believe you. He landed a few. Started along the boards, and there was LaRue pinching up. Kordick said, why, I oughta.
Through again. If he had ice before, he's got ice again. There's Kordick on the far side. And
quad, three on two. Now a fight breaking out the other way. It's Webb in the corner going with big Dan Kordick.
Kind of mismatch in size, and Kordick is using that advantage right now as he throws in a lot of punches. But Stevie Webb, I mean, he may not win a lot of fights, but he'll go.
Now Kordick gets him down and doesn't want to continue the public, but Webb won't win many fights, but he is one of the gamest guys you'll see around. He will be involved with just about everybody. He's fought all the tough guys in the league so far.
Well, that'll be, when you always think about something.
Rest of those seven goals and get some more tonight.
Brent Myers is going to go with Dan Kordick. A fight right off the bat. Myers just up to the Myers. Got the left hand free, and he got Kordick, and down goes Kordick. Brent Myers just called up from San Antonio. You know he's called up for the very reason that you just saw. He fights a lot. He had 98 penalty minutes in 11 games in San Antonio. He wanted Daniels. Daniels left him, and so he got Kordick instead, and Myers handled himself well, and he's talking his way to the penalty bench, Jerry.
Well, he's really kind of a space cadet. He's wearing number 74 from 33 because nobody else in the National Hockey League has it. Now, if that isn't an instigating penalty, I don't know what is. But he got free with that left hand and caught Kordick with a couple of good ones.
They each get five for fighting.
Behind the play, Langdon and Kordick. Langdon's first game back since missing time with the sprained knee.
The size of Kordick. He's trying very hard to knock the helmet off of Langdon. Langdon's conditioning here will be really monitored because he just hasn't played much. Ooh, there's a wild right that just missed. There's another counter and another counter. Langdon's helmet all over the place here, but it seems like the strap must be a good one. Kordick's left got loose for a moment. Yeah, he's big, man. Ooh, is he big? Yeah, this Langdon is some.
Does a pretty,
uppercut, Sam.
Well, he does a pretty good job in controlling.
Oh, man, he landed one there. He's really come alive here. You can see the size of Kordick there. There, Langdon, he snuck a few in there. Quite a few. Flyers-Ranger game in the first period. We're 3:07 in. We've had two goals. We've had a scrap. We've seen an offside goal that was scored by the Flyers. A little bit of everything.
And both teams complaining about the same thing. Lethargy, not enough passion in their game. Well,
boy, the Flyers.
They're displaying it right here.
The Flyers. 35 points, 1 point behind New Jersey. You can see right off the faceoff how it gets started back over there. But Sam, the Flyers, you'd think by listening and hearing about their hockey club, you would think that they were out of the playoff picture.
Going in.
Dan Kordick is ready to go in front. Kordick and Brashear. Brashear, it's a left, Kordick to left, rock'em sock'em robot time. Who will pop the head up is the question. How they grab. Kordick trying to get the right hand. Free now gets the left. Brashear drags him down. Oh, Brashear caught him with the left. But Kordick hangs right in there and starts firing back. Oh, this is a dandy. Brashear has him pinned up against the glass. Kordick giving him a little noogie there as he tries to get him free. Brashear sort of hanging on now as he has him pinned up against the glass, and the linesman will move in. Oh, Kordick has the right hand cocked as they have some words. Brashear who got cut.
Here's the one that's cut.
Nope, we've had plenty of fighting.
It is Kimball and Kordick.
Well, they've squared off.
Chase. That's Chase. I'm sorry.
Oh, look at Dan Kordick switch hands. What do you know? Surprise, surprise. Dan Kordick was not willing to go with the standoff because they both had pretty good grips the other way. You gotta like that. Boy, that makes a coach's eyes light up. If you understand that intimidation is part of this game, and it's part of the rules, people say, why do they fight in hockey? And it's an easy answer. It's because it's allowed. All you get is a five-minute penalty. Dan Kordick switched hands. Looked pretty good on that one. Surprising. I didn't know he could punch with his left. Flyers drop in.
Flyers would go back to Waz, and look at this, Paul Waz all over Dan Kordick before Kordick is able to get a couple of shots in. Dan Kordick had one thing in mind, and that is try to get even for the pummel of Sean Podine.
Now Paul Waz got several major shots.
He's off, just slugs it behind, and we have a scrap here brewing between Kordick and McKay. Ooh, McKay's got a real good grip. Dan Kordick's going to have to let her rip with the left here. Yikes, that is scary. One guy roundhousing with the right, the other guy roundhousing with the left. Well, Dan Kordick might not be doing much damage right now with these punches, but he's certainly winning these fans over.
We're going to go away for 30 seconds and come back, and you won't miss a thing.
They're in their five-minute fighting penalties that they have just picked up. They both want to punch, so even after they got good grips, they back up. But I think McKay tagged Dan Kordick. He tagged him on that one at least, and then there's another one. Finally, Kordick let go. Oh, that one just missed. And so did that one. McKay was throwing them low. You know, the guy that is not using his most coordinated hand is always at a disadvantage here. And Kordick's right-handed. Did he ever duck at the right time there?
Swinging the stick as he rode Pavanka almost into the Capitol bench. Kordick and Berube being separated by Gord Krasiker, but not for long. They're going to go. The gloves are dropped, and here's the Chief and Dan Kordick. Let's see how Kordick fares against Berube. He didn't fare so well against Brendan Witt in the first period. No punches yet. A lot of positioning, and here they go now. Both tie each other up, and an uppercut, and hands. Kordick responds with some lefts on Berube.
But the Chief caught him with the first couple right to the schnoz. That buckled Kordick's legs. Now Kordick uses his size to just sort of hold off the Chief. But the Chief hit him a couple of times right off the get-go.
decides to go.
Vial.
And Vial and Kordic will square off. Kordic has his helmet knocked off. Vial got a right in there, another right in there. Now Kors the left hands. Kordic trying to get the left hand free. Now the right is free, and he hit him with one. Vial tries the big left. Now Kordic the left. And Vial pounding away with the right. It's rock'em sock'em time. Kordic the left hand, Vial the right. The crowd loving that. Now they're going to hold on to each other a little bit. Kordic has a size advantage here. Although Vial is built like a fire hydrant.
You think they're sucking for air? I mean, you got two tired guys there right now.
And they are out of gas just about, although they're still trying to get the arms free for two or three more punches. They're also talking. They're good, covering the entire ice surface in this one. Oh, left by Vial. He's still got some left. Kordic's left. Still throwing haymakers, these two. Look at the look on Vial's face. Oh, left and may have connected from Vial. Now Vial trying to throw the rights. And finally, Elijah said, are you guys a little tuckered out? And they are.
Shoots, glove saved by Healy, and he holds on.
He gave the blue line.
Dykhouse.
Here we go, Kordic and McSorley. First shift for Dan Kordic, who's replacing Sean Antoski. What a save that was by Glenn Healy.
Kordic, the rookie, recently called up with Antoski out with a bone in his hand.
Got a long left arm that's keeping McSorley's right hand from getting loose. McSorley, a very strong individual. If he gets loose, well, Kordic got a couple in. Did a good job, did the kid.
Gord Brassiker and Pierre Rassico get them apart. So the early test of McSorley by Dan Kordic.
His
fans in the Spectrum love
it. Yeah, sure. Very similar to what Cirla did with Peluso the other night at the Garden. It turned the people on in the Garden. Kordic did a good job. Now watch Dykhouse gain the zone easily here. And this is a big time shot. And Healy, remarkable with a catching glove save, considering it was his very first shot. Then these two just got together. And Kordic did a really good job, again, as you look at that catching glove save. A good job with his right arm keeping McSorley's right arm from getting loose. His left arm, pardon me. Kordic's left arm held McSorley's right arm back, and he never could get loose. So we have a lot of battles here early. As the big kid, Antoski is the regular tough guy in the lineup for the Flyers. He's out with a bad hand. Kordic gets in, and he gets.
And now we're going to have a strap. The gloves are off. Vandenbush on the far side, wrestling right in front of the Hawk bench with Kordic. Then they're both slugging it out with gloves. Kordic and Vandenbush, toe-to-toe, left hands. And now we got two other would-be combatants as Dubinsky is wrestling in the neutral zone with youngster Paul Healy. But what a scrap here, Vandenbush and Kordic. They are just slugging it out with the left hand.
Well, a big size advantage for Kordic, but Vandenbush, a tough customer. Well, he's gone toe-to-toe with a much bigger opponent.
And now they still continue to battle. Now they're into the Philadelphia zone after starting at center ice. Vandenbush and Kordic. Kordic missed with the left, so did Vandenbush. And indeed, a decided size advantage for Kordic, who just got in a good left. Vandenbush tries to answer. Now, they still aren't finished yet. Vandenbush a left. Kordic got in a left. And now, as they come together, the linesmen get in there. What a foul.
What a tough customer this kid is. He had to give up about 20 or 30 pounds in about 8 inches, and now Dubinsky and Healy.
Dubinsky and Healy earlier had wrestled one another to the ice. Then when they got up, things had seemed to calm down, and they almost went back at it again, but the officials got there.
It's been quite a day. They're both guys landing a ton of lefts. Oh. They hit so many lefts, who were begging for a right.
Nash on the far side, wrestling right in front of the Hawk bench with Cordick. Then they're both slugging it out with lefts. Cordick and Vandenbush toe-to-toe, left hands, and now we got two other would-be combatants as Dubinsky is wrestling in the neutral zone with youngster Paul Healy. But what a scrap here, Vandenbush and Cordick. They are just slugging it out with the left hands.
Well, a big size advantage for Cordick, but Vandenbush, a tough customer. Well, he's gone toe-to-toe with a much bigger opponent.
And now they still continue to battle. Now they're into the Philadelphia zone after starting at center ice. Vandenbush and Cordick. Cordick missed with the left, so did Vandenbush. And indeed, a decided size advantage for Cordick, who just got in a good left. Vandenbush tries to answer. They still aren't finished yet. Vandenbush a left, Cordick got in a left. And now as they come together, the linesmen get in there. What a bout.
Well, it's been quite a day. They're both guys landing a ton of lefts. Oh. They hit so many lefts who were begging for a right.